Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Let's talk about persistence and mobility of pollutants. We have discussed about these terms before as well. Persistence means that how stable a pollutant is in the environment, how long life the pollutant has in the environment, because almost every pollutant has a certain life after which it can be degraded either naturally or obviously by other factors as well. And how mobile a pollutant is means उसमें कितनी ability है कि वो move कर सके एक जगह से दूसरी जगह में. जितना वो mobile होगा उतना उसका widespread effect आएगा on the living organisms. Now how persistent a pollutant is, that depends on lot of things, especially on its chemical structure. कि उसका जितना strong structure होगा chemical उतना वो ज़्यादा stable होगा, उतना ज़्यादा वो degradation को resist करेगा और उतना longer वो survive करेगा in the environment. Environmental persistence is a particularly important factor in pollution and is often linked to mobility and bioaccumulation. जितना ज़्यादा वो persistent होगा environment में उतना chance है उसका कि वो widespread हो जाए और move कर जाए एक जगह दूसरी जगह पे और उससे living organisms expose हो जाए और ultimately that pollutant may also find its way in the tissues of the living organisms, जिसको हम bioaccumulation कहते हैं. So जितना ज़्यादा ये steps इसे cover करता जाएगा उतने ज़्यादा इसके toxic effects बढ़ते जाएंगे. Highly toxic chemicals which are environmentally unstable and break down rapidly are less harmful than persistent substances, even though these may be intrinsically less toxic. ऐसे सब्सटेंसेस जो कि बहुत ज़्यादा टॉक्सिक हैं लेकिन वो परसिस्टेंट नहीं है, वो जल्दी डिग्रेड हो जाते हैं एनवायरनमेंट में. सो वो जो ही स्पिल हुआ एनवायरनमेंट में वो डिग्रेड हो गए कुछ ही अरसे बाद, तो बहुत कम लिविंग ऑर्गेजम्स उससे इफेक्ट हुए नेगेटिवली. ऑन द अदर हैंड इफ देर इज अ पोलूटेंट विच इज दो नॉट मच टॉक्सिक बट इट इज मच मोर परसिस्टेंट, वेन दैट काइंड ऑफ पोलूटेंट इज स्पिल्ड इन द एनवायरनमेंट, इज इंट्रोड्यूस इन द एनवायरनमेंट बाय एनी मीन्स, though it is not much toxic, but due to its persistence, it will stay there for much longer period of time, and it will start affecting the surrounding living organisms for much longer period of time, ultimately causing much more harmful effects on the health of living organisms as compared to a pollutant, which was though much more toxic, but was not stable, was not persistent. Now about something about mobility of the pollutants. The tendency of a pollutant to disperse or dilute is very important factor in its overall effect, since this affects concentration as well as exposure to the living organism. हम पहले भी ये तस्करा करते रहे हैं कि जितना pollutant mobile होगा उतना वो move करेगा in the environment and और उतने ज़्यादा living organisms expose होंगे उससे. और second ये इसके dispersal में भी आता है और उसके harmful effects में भी आता है. इसके अलावा द मोस्ट फाउंड वे ऑफ मोबिलिटी ऑफ पोलूटेंट्स इज ऑब्वियसली बाय वाटर और बाय एयर. सो इफ अ पोलूटेंट इज सोलेबल इन वाटर एंड इट फाइंड्स इट्स वे इन द वाटर स्ट्रीम्स एंड अल्टीमेटली एंड्स अप इन ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, सो यू कैन असेस हाउ मच हार्मफुल दैट पोलूटेंट कैन बी फॉर द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट आर कंज्यूमिंग दैट ड्रिंकिंग वाटर. So once the toxicant, the pollutant, has found its way to the living organisms, it will start showing its toxic effects through its mode of toxicity, and ultimately it can also end up in the tissues of the living organisms, which we call bioaccumulation. So all these things matter and add to the toxicity of the pollutants. Some pollutants are not readily mobile and tend to remain in hot spots near to their point of origin. There are so many pollutants which are not that much mobile, wo itna move nahi karte, so that's why they are mostly concentrated at their point of origin, jahan se wo aaye hain, jahan se unka origin hai. For example, industrial waste जहाँ पे वो स्पिल हो रहा है उसका, जहाँ पे वो effluent discard कर रहे हैं, throw कर रहे हैं, अगर ऐसा pollutant है जो कि mobile नहीं है वो ज़्यादातर वहीं पे पाया जाएगा because it is unable to move. So that will not cause harmful effect to the other living organisms downstream. However, it will be having much more high toxic effects in its surrounding. क्योंकि वो move नहीं कर रहा, जहाँ पे है वहीं पे है, तो उसकी concentration वहाँ बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ती जा रही है. Whenever a pollutant is mobile, though it affects widespread, its effects is widespread and it affects much more living organisms. However, due to its mobility, its concentration is diluted as compared to being concentrated at one spot. So it is kind of give and take. You can not say that one thing is better over the other, because you can see here that due to mobility of the pollutant, it is though its concentration is decreasing, but it is its effect is widespread. On the other hand, if a pollutant is not mobile, though its effect would not be widespread, but it will be much more in high concentration at the its location as compared to the other pollutant which was mobile. So when we talk about the properties of pollutants and the ways and means to deal with the pollutants, there is not always a best way. It depends on the circumstances, on the pollutants, on the environment, and on the living organisms involved. Whether the pollution is continuous or a single event, and if it is, it has arisen from a single point or multiple sources, form important considerations. Whenever we talk about the toxicity of pollutants, the abilities of the pollutants, their characteristics, their properties, these points should also be considered. कि वो आए कहाँ से हैं, क्या उनका origin single है या multiple source से वो आ रहे हैं, और how they end up in the environment. All these things would matter in the toxicity of that pollutant, and they would also matter in devising techniques to deal with the pollutant and to solve that problem. This was about the persistence and mobility of the pollutants. I will see you in next lessons.